Hi, I'm Klaus, and on this YouTube channel, I do a lot of videos about DaVinci Resolve tips, tricks, filmmaking, and whatnot. But today I want to help newcomers to DaVinci Resolve I want to show them how to get started, how to begin a project, what to do, because it is an huge and enormous program, even if you're using the free version, which I think you should start with, by the way. So the release of DaVinci Resolve 15 has just happened a couple of days ago. So let's get right into it. Let's get going with DaVinci Resolve. So let's go. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is you need to go onto the interwebs and you need to go into Google and type Blackmagic Design. And when you've done that, you'll come into their homepage, and here we are at their homepage. And we just simply need to go to support. And on the support page, we'll just scroll down, or you can just hit the DaVinci Fusion and Blackmagic EPU thing. But since this is at the top here, so what you have to be, you have to notice if you do it this way, there is two versions of the software. The studio version is the paid version. It's like $300. And that is like a one fee you pay, and then you have it forever. And it's a pretty good deal considering what Adobe charges for the monthly subscription. Yeah, just saying. But anyways, you need to go down and download the DaVinci Resolve 15, and you can do that for Mac, Windows, or Linux. So I have already done that, so I'm not going to use my time on that. So when you have installed DaVinci Resolve on your machine, this is the first thing that will occur to you. This is how DaVinci Resolve looks at the opening page here. And DaVinci Resolve is a bit different in that way because DaVinci Resolve is a database system. So that means that all your projects will be within this window here. So the first thing you can do, you can go here and click this icon in the corner, and this will show you your database. So you can either, you can just back up your database or save it or start a new database in this tab. So we'll just close that in. But otherwise, after doing that, we have this, and I have nothing in here because I made a new database, so I wouldn't have all my old stuff there. So either way, I will just hit the Untitled project, and then DaVinci Resolve will just boot up. So this is the first thing. Per default, you'll start in the editing page, but we'll go to the media, and I'll just do a quick run through of the different tabs and what they actually are. So this is the media page, and on the media page, this is where we can import all your media. Up here, you have all your drives on your computers here. And you don't use this tab for very much, by the way. It's just to import, and you don't even have to do that, import that way. But I'll get back to that in a sec. So, and one of the things which are very cool about DaVinci Resolve is that DaVinci Resolve is a linear program. I mean, linear in the way that the workflow is. It's, you know, if you look down here, you have your media, you have your editing tab, you have your Fusion tab, which is the new tab in DaVinci Resolve, which is, it can be quite intimidating when you open that up for the first time. But we'll get into that later on. And then we have your color tab, and this is what DaVinci Resolve is best known for, its color grading capabilities. So back in the day, it was a pretty darn expensive color grading program used in Hollywood only by the big companies or the big studios. So I think like 5, 6, maybe 7 years ago, I don't know the right term, Blackmagic Design bought DaVinci Resolve, and they actually made it a software which were then free for every filmmakers to use, or video creators, because their philosophy is they want to give all creators the same opportunities. And I think that is just great. Anyway, we'll get back to the color tab in a bit. Then we have the Fairlight page, which is also quite new to DaVinci Resolve. It's a couple of years old, but yeah, DaVinci has really developed very much since the version 11. I think editing started to be in version 11. So Anyway, and then of course at the end we have our deliver tab. And this is where we'll do all our delivery. So this is just a super duper quick overview of what's in the software. So let's get started. Let's go back to the media tab. And in the media tab out here, we have all our drives. And I know that on this drive here, I have a lot of material. So let's drag something in. If we open this one, this is like stock footage. So we have like a bunch of stock footage here, which I can just apply. And the way this works is everything you see here is my hard drive. And down here I have the media pool. And in the media pool, that is where all my clips are alive or are living. That's where they are. So let's say we're going to take, there's a lot of clips here. So let's take all of those. A lot of stock clips. We'll just drag those down. And now all these clips are inside of our editing software. And then of course, and now this is a bunch of, and this is so messy, and this is not the right way to do importing your media at all, I think, because a smarter way would be to add bins. So if you right click, you will see this appear and you can add a bin, and then we have bin one, and then we'll call this, stock. So we have like now the master bin and a stock bin, and then we could of course do different categories and whatnot. So let's see what we have. We really have a lot of stuff here. So I'll just take all which is audio. Oh, I'll take all which is video here. I have a lot of stock here. Looks fun. And I'll just drag that up in the stock folder. So, and then I'll just go out here, right click and add a bin, and then I'll do a sound. Sound bin here. Okay, and I'll go to the master and I'll just highlight these and drag those to the sound bin, just like that. So, and DaVinci Resolve also have a feature called smart bins, and smart bins is essentially like a bin, but a smart bin, so it'll work on metadata. I'm not going to show it now because it's really, really, really nerdy, and it'll be a way too long video if I start to go all nerd out on you guys. So, so let's say I just want to import one more thing, by the way. So yeah, okay, and then I have just two clips here, raw clips. I'll just drag those down here, and then I'll just do a new bin. I'll call this raw, and I'll just do the same again. Whoops. Okay, so let's say we have done all our import of the media we want in our project.